Okay, well, short and sweet. I
can keep asking questions, man. I got all kinds of questions for you.
Lay on, Skillet. All
right, what is your honest opinion of the Boondock Saints TV show that they're going to be making?
Fucking get right to the heart of it. You know, I've read some shit online where they're going to have, like, you know, strong women characters because somebody chimed in. I don't know, it sounds a little PC to me. I mean, in the first one, it was like a little wrist type shit. You know what I mean? Could not be more offensive. I don't know. Me and Rich have nothing to do with it. Boondock Saints is a very, very, very important part of our lives. I assure you guys that it would take something significant for us to not want to pursue a part three. It would take something significant. Everybody has a never. Everybody. Eventually you'll get there. You can think, man, I would never have it. But eventually you go, you know what? That's fucked up. And I will leave it at that. But Rita's one of our best friends on the planet. He and I see eye to eye. And you know what I mean? When you get bitch slapped so many times, you have to go, motherfucker, I'll crack you back. I'll fucking crack you. And it's a huge part of our lives. Huge part of our lives. Huge part of our lives.
Yes.
Fucking ripping a toilet out of the ground.
Yeah! Yeah!
And this is what fucking Duffy says. He goes, you know, so we got this styrofoam. I'm like, fuck styrofoam. Bitch, have you said fucking Jack and Swole, motherfucker?
That's great.
Yes, ma'am.
So I
want to
ask you about Jane 2.
Uh-huh.
And do you have any other books in you that you're working on and that you want to like put through the system?
That's my Jeopardy thing. For those of you guys who don't know, I wrote a book. I know you're thinking an actor wrote a book.
Oh my god, how cute.
I actually moved out to LA to become a writer. True story. And then something else got in the way. It was a train that I literally hopped on. I was like, fuck, it's going fast. Let's get it. I get to pull the horn. it's a story that I always wanted to write. I wrote for a number of periodicals, and Jane Pratt, the editor of Jane Magazine, saw something I wrote for Details Magazine. She said, I'd love for you to write from a magazine. I had no idea what it could possibly lead to a woman's magazine. I thought it was like Cosmopolitan, like giving, you know, educational tutorials on fellatio and shit like that. I don't know. But she said, why don't you write about your first kiss? I said, wow, serendipity. Oddly enough, I've always wanted to pen this piece. I always wanted to write it as my first novel. But I will write it as a short story for you. It came out in 1998, and a lot of companies came out of the woodwork to get the rights to